Let's consider this scenario. A bum is sitting on a bench in a nice neighborhood. How you perceive that situation is entirely up to your current level of consciousness. So before break, we are going to make a break in a minute. Just let's see, how do people perceive that seemingly simple situation, bum sitting on a bench in a fine, nice neighborhood, depending on their level of consciousness. People on the level of shame will perceive bum as a dirty, disgusting, and disgraceful. At the level of guilt, he would be blamed for his condition. He deserves what he gets. Probably he is a lazy welfare cheat. It's about guilt. Who is guilty? People at the level of apathy will say, this is evidence that society cannot do anything about homelessness. It is hopeless. It is a problem that cannot be solved. Level of grief. Old man looks tragic and friendless. At the level of fear, bum is threatening a social menace. We should call the police before he commits some crime. Because world is perceived as frightening. At the level of desire, he represents a frustrating problem. Why does somebody not do something? It's a frustrating problem. In anger, old man looks like he could be violent. One could be furious that such condition even exists. At the level of pride, he's seen as embarrassment or lacking the self-respect to better himself. Then we are crossing the threshold and we are coming to courage. And suddenly we might be motivated to wonder if there is a local homeless shelter. Maybe all he needs is a job and a place to live. It's not about blaming. It's not about who is the guilty party. It's not unsolvable problem. It is maybe something that we can contribute to. Maybe we can help him somehow. On the level of neutrality, the bum looks okay, maybe even interesting. Live and let live. He's not hurting anyone. I mean, that's maybe not my choice. I wouldn't like to be homeless. However, he's choosing that condition and I'm fine with that. On the level of willingness, we might decide to go down there and see what we can do to cheer him up. On the level of acceptance, the man on the corner looks intriguing. He probably has an interesting story to tell. He is here for reasons we may never understand. At the level of reason, he is a symptom of the current economic and social malaise. So we would think about it a little bit, intellectualize, do maybe some experiment or study. But now we are crossing the threshold of 500 and 600, and at these higher levels of love and joy and peace, the old man begins to look not only interesting, but friendly and even lovable. Perhaps we should then be able to see he was in fact one who has transcended social limits and gone free. A joyful old guy with the wisdom of age in his face and serenity that comes from indifference to material things. Maybe he is smarter than we are. We accept his condition and suddenly we see benefits of it. And of course, at levels of 600 and more, we see bum as our own inner self in its temporary expression. So, how you perceive life has nothing to do with external circumstances. It's about what you do with them. It's about your level of understanding, your level of consciousness, because you are creating your own reality.